Well, hello there, everybody. Dre here, and welcome back to the Gold Rush. Today, as you can see, I have been playing with the front-end loader a little bit. I decided to get back to building an open-pit mine, or at least trying my best to with this crazy bedrock that we have. And I've actually extracted a lot of the annoying stuff, at least in the main place that we dug, and I'm kind of getting over to where in the last episode we got some of the biggest gold yields we've ever got, which was right here. So the goal right now for me is to hopefully be able to build a roadway all the way down to when the ground flattens out over here. I don't know if we can see through the ground anymore. I have been digging a little bit, but yeah, you can see just a little bit. The ground basically flattens right here. If I can dig a roadway all the way down to here, we are golden, and then we should be able to push out the wall a little bit. And, yeah, we might get the open pit mine that I actually wanted. So, I've been doing a little bit off recording, and, I think what we're gonna do today is move a lot of this dirt over here, expand this out a little bit, and obviously try and go deeper down this, get it to bedrock, and maybe by the end of the episode, we might be able to have a little bit of an open pit mine going on. I mean, it kinda is an open pit mine right now, but it's not perfect, that's for damn sure. So, I forgot that I actually already filled this thing. We should have another clean out ready, so I guess we could start by doing that. Clean outs are always fun. So yeah, let's go put this through the system and see what kind of gold we're on right now.
Give me the gold, Papa.
All right, we got a little less than one bucket in all of the moss mats. Now, obviously, it's not going to be as good as the last two episodes of yields because we were pinpointing the gold then. Right now, I'm basically just picking up dirt from the bedrock, and that's all this is. So, I don't know what we're going to get out of these. Hopefully, it's somewhat decent, but you know what? It doesn't matter. Gold in the bank is better than no gold in the bank, regardless of what it is. So, let's get it started now. And do a really quick clean out. Not many buckets, as you can see. So this shouldn't take too long at all. And I want to get it back out, hopefully before nighttime, and start digging further into our mine. Well, I gotta say, I don't know what this bucket is, but we have 12% of magnetite already. What the hell is in this bucket? Hold the front door, man. What is this? Okay, so we have zero gold right now. 84 first pour. Holy crap. Okay, I thought this was gonna be real bad. Is this gonna be our best freaking bucket? We're at 1,000! What the hell was in that? Okay, I always do this. I have to remember. Put the damn bucket back! Is that our biggest bucket? I honestly forget. Was it 1,500? Because I just think we got our biggest bucket. Here I am saying this is gonna be a crappy payday. And that's the fun thing of Gold Rush. You never really know what you're gonna get. And lately, the ground has been really nice to me, so I'm not gonna complain at all. God, I hope the rest of these buckets are half this good, but judging by the magnetite that's going much slower now, that was by far our best bucket. What does this bucket have in it? I think that's probably a planter bucket. If that's a planter bucket, goddamn, son, 321 grams in there as well. This is great. I love Gold Rush right now because I'm making so much friggin' money when I'm actually smelting the gold, mind you, and not selling it for a ridiculously low price. Yeah, that was definitely a planter bucket, though. So, I'm getting over 300 grams in planter buckets. Damn. This might be our biggest clean-out ever. And 321 again. This will be another 321. So, planters alone is giving me 1,200. Damn, man, this is amazing. Now, these buckets should be a little bit better. I think that was the last planter bucket anyways. We're already at 25% magnetite in one cleanout. What the hell is this game right now? Why isn't it always like this? Still think we're gonna hit it anyways, and yes, indeed, we are. What's going to be the yield of this one? Is that the top bucket? I'm not sure what this one would be. Ooh, 13,000 grams of magnetite? Okay, so that was a planter bucket. Clearly, I lost count, but this will be another big payday bucket, and are we going to get the big 4,000 in one cleanout? It's going to be close, I think. I don't know if we're going to hit it, though. Oh, 7%. We're almost there. Come on, we did it. 424, 973 grams in that, and that was the top bucket. Jesus, man. Here I am thinking that was just going to be a quick cleanout of just a little bit. God, this is going so nice right now. This is gonna be a good year of gold mining, man. All right, and let's utilize a little bit of this light left to start digging as quickly as possible, because I don't know how easy this is gonna be when it's dark out. So yeah, Not bad, man. 4,000 grams already today. We should have enough time to do at least another clean out. Mind you, it's going to be slow grabbing the dirt now because we basically... well, it's very hard to maneuver in there, to say the least. So we'll see how quickly we can do this, but we should be pretty good. I'll align that later. So yeah, I think... You know what? I'm going to try and go a little bit deeper right now. I was going to get the stuff behind me just so it's a little bit easier to maneuver in here, which I definitely will do maybe in the middle of the night. That should be easy to get in the middle of the night because the light goes over there, and I'm too lazy to move the light down to here. But the issue I'm having now is this incline is so aggressive, I have to be very careful with my controls here or I do get stuck down here. So I'm going to take my sweet time, and we're definitely not going to move a lot of dirt today. But we should. I mean, all I need to do is make a roadway down here. That's really all I need to do. And as you can see, we're getting dirt. And we are seeing bedrock. Damn it, I just lost all my dirt. And that, oh, never mind, it's there. Okay, random glitches. Sometimes I do lose all my dirt, though. Because we're on such of an incline that it actually falls out of the bucket sometimes. But yeah, this is really good dirt, clearly. So I do want to keep as much of this as I can. Because we just had, I think it was our second biggest bucket. If I remember correctly, our biggest was around 1900. So, I mean, this stuff is really good ground. All right, and it's beautiful morning time. And I gotta say, this is actually going a lot better than expected. As long as I take my time, I really don't get stuck. I do have a hard time getting buckets down here, though, just because of the weird terrain. But, as you can see... The old baby struggles, but we can get up this giant hill, so I think officially we should be okay. I've also mined out all the stuff behind us just to give us more room to do this a little quicker. And I got about 3 dump trucks over the night, which is actually a lot faster than I thought it would take to get through some of this terrain. So yeah, this kind of excites me because that means we should... I mean, I think we're at the steepest part right now. You can see it drops down a lot here. But we should be able to get our open pit mine started, which makes me really, really excited because I love the front end loader. I hate driving it, but just with the size of the bucket on this thing, it makes a lot more sense to use this besides the excavator. We should be almost having another full clean out now, and I'm kind of excited. I mean, I didn't expect to get a lot of gold in the last one. We definitely should get a lot of gold in this one because we're going down to the deepest part of some of the best veins we've ever seen. So this could be our biggest bucket yet, and we might have like a 10,000 gram day. Now also, looking at the gold map, it's not actually as bad as I thought. I said multiple times I was going to do 2 different open pit mines here, but I think there's still a little bit of gold here, so I think we're just going to mine through this. Even over here, I know there's almost no gold, but it would take me not too long if we have an open pit mine to mine this all out. So we'll probably make one big mine here after all, and that should be fun. That will be really cool to see too, because this is really deep ground. I'm excited to see how deep exactly it goes. I'm hoping we can get to the flat ground today, but I have to go extremely slowly through this, so I don't know if we're going to actually reach the flat ground. We should get close, though. Well, I just hit something I'm a little worried about. We got an even steeper incline down here, and I'm actually having a hard time even grabbing the dirt because the game, for whatever reason, you need to kind of have the bucket flat or like horizontal, I should say, to actually start scooping dirt. Well, we're so far on an incline, it thinks the bucket's all the way down. And I'm actually having a real hard time sticking into the dirt right now. And you can see I'm sliding into the wall. That's when I have issues. So it's becoming a little bit of a pain. I think I'm going to widen this area out. The odd thing is I wasn't sliding before. And now I kind of am. As long as I'm not getting stuck, we're okay. But I've kind of halted to a standstill when it comes to grabbing the actual dirt. So there's a few ways to go about this. Obviously, I think the best thing would be to maybe, now that we have enough room, bring the excavator down here and start digging it out with the excavator, maybe in the next episode. I just want to see if maybe I can get down here and get into it. It's just, it's not easy, and we're going into a deeper incline. You can see my wheels are kind of off the ground because I'm trying to push the shovel so low. I'm kind of stuck right here. unfortunately, and I thought we would have it. Damn it. The benefit being, as you can see, we've extracted pretty much all the way to the wall. So that's good. But now I'm going to have to really get crafty if we want to beat this hill here. And we're kind of going to have to if we want to have an actual open pit mine. I mean, we had the strategy of maybe digging a hole out with the excavator and then just dropping vehicles down into it. That could be another option that we do. I really want a roadway down there, though. That makes things like refueling a lot easier. I'm trying my best, guys. I really do want this open pit mine. Let me go this way maybe a little bit. I mean, yeah, I guess that would be smart. Maybe going down on a little bit of a sideways incline so it's not so steep. Problem is, it is just such a slow process to do this right now. But it's fine. We're on the gold. It's all good. And we did a lot today. Like, I expanded this so much. We got rid of all the junk that was up here. And I'm now determined more than ever to turn this thing into an open pit mine. Because I think it's going to look so cool. And it's going to be obviously really good for getting that gold quickly as well once we get over this hill. All right, but that should be it for today, I'm thinking. I'm kind of all gold mined out. And we should have enough for our next dump truck here. Meaning we should have another clean out to do. Which I know is a lot of your favorite parts. So yeah. We'll bring this dump truck over and see if we can beat 4,000, because that's what we already got today. All right, and here we are with another clean out, and oh man, I'm excited. So these are the big boys. I think we'll start with the planter buckets first, and let's waste no time, get right into it. We might even need to throw my magnetite into the thing by the end of this. If we can get 100% bucket, that would be amazing. I don't know if this one's going to be better than the last. The thing with the last cleanout is I did have a bit of dirt from the last episode still in all of my systems. And yeah, just judging by the magnetite in the bucket right now, we're actually going to get a little less than last cleanout because of probably that dirt that was already in the system that was the really, really good dirt from the last episode. But still, this should be a really good payday. I don't think it's going to be as good as 4,000, though. But if we can get 7,000 total, that's a pretty good payday of gold earning. Let's see what's in these planter buckets, though. That's the big answer. If there's a lot in the planters, chances are we're going to have a pretty good payday. And ending off with 207. That's actually, didn't we have 300 and something before? It's a lot less. Okay. So maybe this isn't going to be as good as I thought. Whoa. I must have did the wrong bucket, because that's 13,000. Yes, this is definitely one of the good buckets. We're going to keep those over here. I definitely want to do the planters first, save the best for last. I accidentally grabbed the wrong bucket, my bad. But still, I think we know that's going to be a pretty good bucket. Okay, and the planter buckets are done, almost at 5,000 grams. Let's start doing this one right away. I believe this is probably the top grade bucket. I hope it's not the moss mats, because if it's the moss mats, this is going to be lower than expected, and these last two should be the moss mats, I think. The big question is this going to be a pretty good payday or not? I don't know. I only have 5,300 right now. Not that I'm complaining, that's still a crap load of money, but I'm expecting a lot right now. I'm a little worried. Ooh, what? That was the moss mat bucket. So we got 972 grams. That's going to be our best bucket, unfortunately. So that's a bit of a bummer, but I like how I'm getting 872 grams of gold, and I'm getting mad these days. But yeah, compared to the last cleanout, goddamn, I don't know what we were on. This game, I mean, there's surprises around every corner, and yeah, it's looking like this is actually going to be a pretty kind of medium-tier payout. But hey, that's fine. We got a little bit left in this. I'm just going to let it join that. And there was only like 1% in that bucket anyways. So what we end off with, 59% magnetite, 752 grams of gold with the moss mat, and a little bit of the grate. So we ended off with 6.5. Compared to the 4,000 we got before, got to say that's a little sad. We didn't miss a bucket, did we? I don't think we did. So yeah, definitely we had some really good dirt through the system at the start because, man, that first bucket was absolutely fantastic. But still, 6,500 grams for one day of gold mining, not bad at all. And once we get deeper into this ground, I think it's going to get even better. Especially when we hit the flat ground and we can move dirt a hell of a lot faster. All right, so I'm not going to melt my gold today. I want to actually start saving the gold for when the gold price is at an opportunistic moment. I haven't actually looked at the gold price, but I it's usually really good at the start of winter from what I've found. So let's actually go to the bank and check. So yeah, stock is, as you can see, a little down right now. If we go to the 1 year, actually, maybe I should go. Damn, son. Okay, that's why you should look at 1 year. Yeah, you know what? I mean, it's just starting to drop. I think it's probably going to drop through the rest of the year. So I'm actually going to go clean this stuff up. We probably won't earn a lot more money if we sell it now. But if the price is right, we may as well go do it right now. All right, and let's see the damage today. That was an absolutely awful park job, so that's a bad sign. Hopefully, we can at least sell these bars for a decent profit. Usually they're about, what, 20 grand? I don't know. It's actually been a while since I've sold gold bars. Never mind, they're 100 grand. Why did I think they were 20? What the hell's wrong with me? Holy crap! I'm so mad for doing that mistake in the last episode of selling the gold to the blacksmith. Because we lost 60% of our yield, and now as you can see, I mean, it's not too hard to earn money in this game anymore. We're at 442. We need two point something to buy the next claim, so it's not even summer yet. I think we're well on our way to buying that next claim for the next season, and that excites me to say the least. But yeah, we're gonna wrap up this one here, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, building the start of our open pit mine. And yeah, in the next episode, we'll probably get the excavator down there if we need it and actually start, you know, forming a little bit of an open pit mine there, because I'm excited to start moving as much dirt as quickly as possible and driving drunk, clearly. But yeah, I want to thank you guys once again for all your support. Thanks so much for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.